People always ask me why I'm smiling. Well, let's just say, while others build castles in the sand, I prefer watching them crumble in flames. It's not evil, it's just fun.
I forgot to write a prompt here, but I'm sure you won't. Let's understand how we can use this sound-to-image video model. Make sure you update your comfyUI using this update batch file. I will get the workflow from the comfyUI template. This is the workflow we will be looking at. The workflow may look complicated, but it is simple. Let's understand. Below is a similar workflow, which is inactive. The difference here is the LoRa loader, which is missing. It is present in the above workflow. This means if you want to use an accelerator like LightX2V LoRa to increase the generation speed, then use the workflow above, or else use the workflow below. Without any accelerator, this workflow takes 20 steps to generate a finished result, but the workflow above will generate in just 4 steps. I tried it with the LoRa, but the quality was bad. The LoRa works, but I think there should be a dedicated LoRa for this sound-to-video model. The one recommended right now in the workflow was made for WAN 2.2 high and low noise models. This is where all the safe sensor models are selected, and below we can upload the audio file and the image. This is for prompt, and on the right is the sampling nodes, which includes the new WAN sound image to video. You should get this after updating the comfyUI. These 3 sections and the input node should be enough to work. This video node with a VAE will also be needed. In this section, these 3 nodes are to keep the generation process active, which will be appended in the video to make it longer. The batch size and chunk length are the values for the 3 nodes we saw above. The below sampler nodes are the values for the K-sampler above. The reason it is not directly given to the K-sampler is because the same values are used to extend the video length. This section is about fixing the overbaked frame. If we look at the first frame of this video generated, the exposure seems to be very high.
This is a test of QWEN 2.2. What do you think of the results? This is a test of QWEN 2.2. What do you think of the results?
The frames after that looks normal. So if I just take this part, the node necessary to make it work, this looks simple. The nodes on the left are common, but this audio encoder node is from the new update. This node takes the language model, and the below node takes an audio file. The audio file and the language goes to the sound image to video node. The workflow template also included the file names we need to download. And below is the folder where you need to place those files. Let's look at the files quickly. The BF16 is the larger file. And below is the smaller FP8 file for the smaller graphic card. The FP8 file was uploaded by Kijai as well, which also includes a WAN 2.1 model. You can try the smaller GGUF model if you are using an 8 or 12 gigabyte card. These models should work with a UNET loader node for GGUF files. So that was for the diffusion model files. This audio encoder file is new in the process, and it can be saved inside models and then the audio encoder folder. If the folder is missing, then you can create it by yourself. These text encoder and VAE are common, which goes to their respective folders. I will add the UNET loader for the GGUF model and make a connection. Select Q4 model, which should work on 12 gigabyte memory. For the audio, I need a copyright-free audio file with an image to make it work. So I have used the Q4 model and added the Sage Attention node to speed up. But the speed up will be around 10 to 15% only. You can watch the older videos to set up Sage Attention. The resolution is 512 pixels for 81 frames. The other values were as it was before. This is the audio file.
In the ancient land of Eldoria, where skies shimmered and forests whispered secrets to the wind, lived a
5 seconds of this audio should be used in the video. Let's look at the result. For some reason, the play button is missing. You can add the video combine node. I have kept things simple.
In the ancient land of Eldoria, where skies shimmered and forests whispered secrets. In the ancient land of Eldoria, where skies shimmered and forests whispered secrets.
So, these were the necessary nodes to make it work. The workflow by comfyUI with FP8 model and LoRa. All the settings are at default. Let's check the 14-second result, which took 11 minutes to generate.
In the ancient land of Eldoria, where skies shimmered and forests whispered secrets to the wind, lived a dragon named Zephyros. Not the burn-it-all-down kind, but he was gentle, wise, with eyes like...
Now I will activate this node to extend the video length further. The seed ID and other details are the same, so the process started directly on the third node. I canceled the generation because I forgot to increase the batch size, which should be 4. The logic here is 1K sampler and 3 extend nodes. After 275 seconds, I got the result.
In the ancient land of Eldoria, where skies shimmered and forests whispered secrets to the wind, lived a dragon named Zephyros. Not the burn-it-all-down kind, but he was gentle, wise, with eyes like old stars. Even the birds fell silent when he passed.
She was not able to whisper. If anyone is running a 32-gigabyte card, then you can try with a BF16 model. Here, I don't see the expression. The lip movement is present, but the expression is missing. You can also use the chatterbox text-to-audio node. It does the job with less resources and should work easily on an 8-gigabyte card.
In the smoky caves of Bronzefang, where gold glittered brighter than the sun, lived a dwarf named Thrain. Not the battle-hardened axe-wielder kind, more like the got-stuck-in-his-own-helmet kind. Even the anvils seemed to sigh when he entered.
I will paste the node here and make some space here. Press Ctrl plus C to copy and paste using Ctrl Shift V. I hope this looks clear. This is the third node, and the latent output from this node should be an input to the new node added. I will delete this output and keep the third node behind the fourth. Output from the third node goes to the fourth node, and then the output by the last node will be used for video. To have 16 frames in every second for a 25-second video, I will need a total of 400 frames, which should be divided between all. That is 1K sampler and 4 extend nodes. I have added some text in the chatterbox node, and this load audio node will be replaced. I have made both the connection and disabled the load audio node. The generation starts with chatterbox. The audio length is 24 seconds. The time taken to generate the result was 20 minutes using the FP8 model. Let's check the result.
I joined the gym last week, and so far, I've lost nothing, except my wallet, my patience, and the ability to walk upstairs without crying. The trainer keeps saying, "No pain, no gain." Meanwhile, I'm in so much pain, I'm considering claiming it as a dependent on my taxes. At this point, the only thing lifting heavy weights is my regret for signing that 1-year membership.
I see some defects with the eyes, the rest looked okay. I queued the workflow again, which took 21 minutes with a smaller queue for KMGGUF. Let's check the result.
I joined the gym last week, and so far, I've lost nothing except my wallet, my patience, and the ability to walk upstairs without crying. The trainer keeps saying, "No pain, no gain." Meanwhile, I'm in so much pain, I'm considering claiming it as a dependent on my taxes. At this point, the only thing lifting heavy weights is my regret for signing that 1-year membership.
I have added the block swap node for slower graphic cards. This offloads some computational tasks from the GPU to the CPU. However, it may affect generation speed, so gradually increase the block swap value if generation fails due to a larger model. The maximum it can do is 40 blocks. The video generation is slow, and the quality is on the lower side, but this was the first step towards sound and video generation. The next release on this model should be interesting.
In the digital kingdom of Scrolloria, where memes traveled faster than light and hashtags sparked... Digital kingdom of Scrolloria, where memes traveled faster than light and hashtags sparked wars, lived an influencer named Blaze. Not the motivational quotes at sunrise kind. More like the oops, I live streamed my fridge kind.